Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your guide in the race to financial freedom through real estate investing and sound financial practices. This podcast is for anyone interested in learning more about real estate investing, personal finances, and a new take on traditional retirement. Now, here are your hosts, Larry Fierro and Mike Moe.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your guide on the race to financial freedom through real estate investing and sound financial practices. This is your Monday morning motivation edition, where we follow up on our call to action from the previous episode. We hit you with a little motivation to start your Monday morning off, right? And then we tee up our episode to come. And with me today, my partner in crime, Mr. Fierro. What's up, man? How you doing?
Mike, I'm doing pretty good tonight. How about yourself, my friend?
I can't complain, man. I got a little Memorial Day weekend, and you got out on the camper a little bit this weekend, didn't you?
I did.
That,
you know,
that camper that your tenant so graciously paid for over the last handful of years?
I'm telling you, I shared a picture of the truck and the camper getting ready to get it all ready to go and everything, and got a lot of feedback about it. And the fact that financial independence is basically every day for me now. And that's
yes,
that's a good thing there. 100%, 100% real estate.
Yes. Yes, sir, man. All right, dude, we had a really good episode last week. We talked about business, about entrepreneurship. We covered, you know, everywhere from strategizing and writing the business plan to the implementation and execution. So we covered a ton around business, but the call to action on that was really to, you know, if you're thinking about starting a business, if you're ideating about the business or you're in the process of it, you really want to make sure it hits three main boxes, right? Something that you're good at, you know, should be within your core competencies, something that you are effective or at least better than your average bear at, right? Something that you are passionate about, or at least something that you like, right? It's going to take a ton of man hours, a ton of woman hours, whatever, a ton of hours in general to build this business from scratch. And you want to make sure that it's something that you enjoy doing because it's going to make that easier. And the third thing, something that's profitable, right? So you don't want to start a business that you really love to do, but there's no money in, because that's a hobby and that's cool. We can have hobbies. We don't want to start a business on that. So really, if you can see, check those three main boxes, you're going to increase your likelihood of having success in that business.
Yeah. And a business, like you said, the hobby can turn into a business, but you got to make sure that it's something that you really love doing, because if you turn a hobby into a business, a lot of times it becomes a chore.
Yeah.
And, you know, if you enjoy it that much that a chore doesn't bother you, then that's perfect. Just do your hobby as a business and make some money at it. But if it's a hobby that you don't want to stop liking doing, then definitely keep it as a hobby, because if you get into that and you have to do it and it becomes a chore, that could kill your passion for it. And that's not a good thing. So, you know, make sure it's something that you really love doing.
Yeah, it definitely could. So yeah, so check the call to action, go back, check those three main boxes, because it's going to increase your likelihood of you having success in that business. Again, something that you like doing, something that you're good at, and something that makes money. Check those three boxes and continue on with building that empire.
Yeah, run with it. You'll be all right.
All right, dude. Into the motivation. We're going to talk a little bit about consistency this week. And I'm going to start it off with a quote, man, a little Aristotle for us. And it goes a little like this. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence then is not an act, but a habit. So man, consistency. Ooh. If you are going to start a business, if you're going to do anything, consistency is way more effective than short bursts of intense effort. It's you're way more effective if you just day in and day out, you're consistent with things versus once a week, twice a month, whatever it is, you know, going at it hardcore for a day. You know, you're way better just doing it day in and day out consistently.
Yeah, you've got to show up every single day and get it done. That's what consistency mainly is. You know, we do this podcast on a weekly basis. We cover a lot of topics. We make sure that we're here for the fans every Monday, every Thursday. We put out good content. We're here consistent, and that's going to show through our quality of our content. It's going to show through the quality of our podcast, and hopefully people are responding, and they have been.
Yeah, for sure, man. I can't remember where I saw it, but somebody said, you know, a month from now, you're either going to have, you know, a month full of excuses or a month full of progress to show what you did, you know. And consistency for me was highlighted a little bit. The importance of it was highlighted a little bit in the last month or so. So I set a goal for myself about a month ago to run 100 miles in a month, which for me, who runs a handful of times a week, you know, 3, 4, 5 miles a time, you know, that's not too bad. It's about a little over 3.5 miles a day, but I wasn't consistent with it, with the move, with, you know, life happening, with things coming up. You know, I let 5 or 6 days go by where I didn't run. And then I got towards the last week, which was this week, and had about 30 miles to do in, you know, 4 days. So consistency, had I been a little bit more consistent with it, had I been a little bit more diligent with the day in and day out versus those short bursts of effort, would have had a little more likelihood of hitting that goal, man.
Yeah. And one of the things, one of the quotes that I like is, how do you eat an elephant? You know, it's one bite at a time.
Yep.
And, you know, you've got a big goal, 100 miles in a month. And if you take little bites at it every day, then you don't have to do 30 miles in 3 days.
Exactly. Yep. It's that consistent day in, day out, get up. We talked a little bit about with Stephen Pressfield, the War of Art, probably a couple months ago now, actually. The hard part is sitting down and putting in the work. It's not about what you do. It's not about the work, because that'll come. But if you can consistently day in and day out, sit down and do that work, you're going to be better off. It's about that consistency of showing up and being a professional and getting that work in.
Yeah, make those goals happen daily, every day. Make sure you show up, get it done. So, and that's an excellent call to action. So what do we got coming up for Thursday, Mike? I'm a little excited about this one coming up.
Dude, we're going to take the business episode a step further. We're going to dive a little bit into corporate culture and around kind of setting the standard of excellence for your business. Because that's important. That's not something you should do all whimsical. You know what I'm trying to say. You should do it diligently, and you should do it. You should have it very intentional about what you're doing with your business and how you're setting the standard for excellence in your corporate culture. So we're going to talk a little bit about that and dive deep into it coming up.
Yeah, setting that standard of excellence, and then the key part of the second part of that is the accountability.
Oh yeah, you know? For sure, so, man.
Yeah, yep. Very excited about the one on Thursday.
Heck yeah, man. All right. Anything else?
No. I think I'm gonna head back out to the camper and continue the Memorial Day weekend festivities.
Heck yeah, man. All right. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. We'll see you next time.
Guys, take care.
Thanks for listening to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. If you found value in any of the content from this show, consider supporting us in the following ways. Subscribe to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. Leave a rating and review. Continue the conversation with like-minded individuals on social media by heading over to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast Facebook group, or follow us on Instagram and Twitter @Real Estate Marathon Podcast.